In this video, we're just going to solve a ton of Euler equations just so you can get practice. So my recommendation is first, of course, review a video that teaches you how to do this, if you haven't already. And then second, take a look at these, pause the video, and then go try to work them on your own, and only come back to either check your answer or whenever you get stuck. So let's pretend that happened. So as I'm looking at this guy, I can immediately write the characteristic equation-y thingy for this Euler equation. So I have 3r plus 2 equals 0. And because I'm super awesome at math, I can possibly, maybe, work this out and get an answer. I don't know why I got confused for a second, but, you know, it happens. Plus 2r equals 0. Okay, so r is equal to negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac over 2a r plus or minus 2r over 2r negative 1 plus or minus I. So that's nice. So that means I can write an equation in the form x to the negative 1, because it's x to the alpha, and then c1 cosine 1 times the natural log of x, so that's just cosine natural log of x, and c2 times the sine of the natural log of x. And not very exciting, but that's about all there is to that one. All right, let's keep going. So I can write this up. I've got r times r minus 1 minus r minus 8. R squared minus r minus r minus 8. R squared minus 2r minus 8. And that's some other kind of answer. What would that be? That's r minus 4. R plus 2, r equals 4, or minus 2. So y is equal to c1, x to the 4, and then c2, x to the negative 2. Chick-a-choo, chick-a-choo, chick-a-choo. Very exciting. If you don't get excited doing this, especially if you've been spending a lot of time doing power series, this should be kind of a relief. So now I have 6, r minus 1, 5, r, and if you're like, I didn't know what I was doing before, but now I do. Well, this is the time to pause the video, sweetie, and see how far you can get. 6r plus 5r minus 1, because it's all about active learning. Minus r minus 1, so that's 3r, I think. Minus 1, 2r. One of these has to be positive, so negative, positive. R is equal to negative 1 third, or 1 half. That means that y is equal to c1, x to the negative 1 third, and c2, x to the positive 1 half. And look at how fast these are. This is really exciting. Okay, uno mas. Doop-a-doop-a-doo. R times r minus 1 minus 5, r plus 9 equals 0. R squared minus 1 minus 5, r plus 9. Isn't algebra kind of relaxing? Especially when you can pretend that you're doing harder math. And by harder, I of course mean funner. And by funner, I of course mean better. So, following our pattern, we have c1 plus c2 natural log of x times x cubed. And that's all we're looking for. Done. Beautiful. Very exciting.